Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1695, Perfect Shuffle Challenge. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. Well, many years ago, we used to have the challenge of the month at Mr. Excel, and I was talking to Dan Mayoh. Dan, as you might remember, did a couple of guest podcasts for us. He was one of the Model Off champions, and Dan proposed that we run this challenge of the month, and I think it's a great one. So, a perfect shuffle of a deck of cards is a trick used by magicians to give the illusion of randomness, when in fact the order of the cards is being controlled. You have to cut the deck into two exactly equal halves, and then perfectly interlace the two halves one card at a time. So, in a typical deck of 52 cards, let's number them from 1 to 52. The left half contains 1 to 26. The right half contains 27 to 52, and they're merged from the bottom up. So the deck ends up in this order: 1, 27, 2, 28, 3, 29, and so on. So here's the interesting thing. If you do a perfect shuffle 7 more times, that deck of 52 cards will be back in the original order. All right, so let's try it. I have a little formula here, which I'm not going to reveal right now, that does the perfect shuffle, and we will do 8 of these. So I'll Control C to copy, Control V to paste. Let's do a little conditional formatting here, conditional formatting, color scales. All right, so we can kind of see the patterns emerge. And sure enough, Dan is correct. We started out here in 1 to 52, do a perfect shuffle 8 times, and you end up in exactly the same order. All right, so that's useful for casinos to know, right? Because if they have a card jar coming in, anyway. So the goal for the challenge of the month here is write an Excel spreadsheet to answer the following question. For each even numbered deck size from 2 cards to 200 cards, what's the smallest number of perfect shuffles required so the deck will be back in the original order? Now, for 4 cards, the answer is 2. For 52 cards, we just saw the answer is 8. What about the other values? Now, we're looking for the simplest and most elegant way of modeling this that you can. Find interesting ways to display the answers and highlight any patterns that you may see emerging. We're particularly interested, and Dan and I have each solved this in different ways, for the 2 to 200. But is there a pattern that would allow us to create a formula that would do this for any number, like 20,000? How many perfect shuffles do you need to get 20,000 without actually modeling a 20,000 by 20,000 array? That's not part of the challenge, but certainly bonus points for that. Let's run it from April 24th today through May 22nd, 2013. Send your workbooks to Bill at MrExcel.com. Now, hey, that email address is down at the office on another computer. It's not checked every day. Don't send me regular email there. Just send the challenge entries there. Judges will be myself, Dan Mayoh, and we'll find someone else. 3 prizes: best without VBA, best with VBA, and then most interesting. And certainly, if someone can solve that 20,000, like any number deck, that would be interesting. And for prizes, so I just saw that Scott put a new bundle up at the store. The ebook bundle, it looks like there's 9 different ebooks there, everything from the most basic Don't Fear the Spreadsheet up through Bob Umlis, the Excel Outside the Box, and Excel Gurus Gone Wild. So something for everybody there. $99 value will ship these 3 ebook bundles to our winners. So there you go, the return of the challenge of the month, building a spreadsheet to model the perfect shuffle for any size deck from 2 to 200 cards. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.